this looks the same as the drone that I lost contact with the FPV over the sea, had blackout, but it's not, because what I've done, I've changed out the camera. So the original camera didn't know me anything. I've been flying for years and had a few crashes with it. So the safest thing, given they're quite cheap, was just to put another one in. It's still the most cost-effective FPV thing, the all-in-one unit that I can think of. So happy with that. The other change I've made, when you look at these two drones, is on this one, I've got a clever mod of a cheap battery checker to give me a warning, a range warning. Unfortunately, it comes on very early when the Bugs 3 software figures the battery's a bit low, which tends to be wrong when you're using high-powered batteries. So what I've replaced it with is the Vify Beacon. This has just come out. I've seen a few reviews of it. The wonderful thing with this, it's got a motion detection in it, and it's got its own battery. So it's a movement sensor. Yeah, so quite a loud beeper, and best of all for me, it's not beeping all the time, so it means people don't come out of their houses if I'm flying in the suburbs and wonder what the hell that noise is in the sky. So with that brief intro, just explaining why I've now got the confidence to fly this one out over the sea. So I hope you enjoy the video.
At this point, I've already flown my EX Mini once and found conditions weren't as tough as they looked, 15 kilometer hour winds. So Alan's away with his Phantom SE again. Getting out over the sea for some good footage. Zipping along. And after that, I took the Bugs 3 up for the first time. So here we go for some cinematic action over the sea.